Let's begin then. Hello and welcome everyone to the Knowledge Happy Hour. I know that we kind of disappointed all our audience yesterday, and that was because Facebook did not really support us and kind of gave up on us last minute. But we have fixed the bug and we are back again, so no stopping to the learning. So once again, welcome everyone to the Knowledge Happy Hour. And today is the 10th episode. And I today have really, really special guest with me. So I have Nidhi Bharadwaj and I also have Sunita Singh. And
Thank
they are
much.
Joining us today. They are joining us today not only as an image consultant, but they are mostly actually joining us today as industry experts. So, as you know that today's topic is about grooming. We are discussing grooming trends, especially in current times. What are the changes that we could be expecting and how we all can maybe learn a little bit more from their experience. So we will be discussing a lot about grooming and grooming trends today. And that's what the session is all about. So all the people who just joined us right now, I welcome all of you. Once again, you haven't missed much. So once again, welcome. And we are going to start our Knowledge Happy Hour on grooming and grooming trend of 2020. Now, I'm your host, Sonia Dubey Divan. And yes, I will be taking you through and with the panel discussion with my two guests today. I will start with the introduction. So let me just give you a quick introduction of both of our esteemed guests. Okay, we are still getting more people. So everyone is still saying hi. Hi, everyone. Hi. All right, I'm just going to give a few more minutes because I feel that a lot of people are coming in now and then I'll have to repeat. So that they don't feel that they have missed much. No, you haven't missed. It just started. Wonderful. Hi there. Hi, Anita. Hello, Ashwin. Hi. Hi, Adarsh. Hi, Shilpa. Hi, Padmaja. Hello, Shraddha. Hi, Rubleen. Hi, Lavanya. Hi, Shalini. Wonderful. Hi, Eugene. Watching from Canada. Wonderful. We have audience from Canada. Great, great. Our Knowledge Happy Hour is going now everywhere and people are just loving it. So yes, it's a great thing that we all can just use this time to learn and grow our knowledge and share our knowledge with each other. Okay, so we have I think we have a lot of people already with us, so let's now once again start. All right, so one more time. Welcome everyone to the Knowledge Happy Hour. I'm your host, Sonia Dubey Divan. And as you know, Knowledge Happy Hour is an initiative by Indian School of Image Management, where we share our knowledge, our experience. We bring in a speaker every day with a different topic, sharing about their inputs on different topics that they are experts in. So similarly, today we have two guests with us and today is a panel discussion. So I welcome Nidhi Bharadwaj and I also welcome Sunita Singh. Welcome.
Hi, Sonia.
Thank you so much.
Having us over.
Both of you can just quickly say hi to your audiences and then I will start with your introduction and let everyone know about you.
Hello, everyone. A very good evening to everyone.
Hello, everyone. Extremely happy to be here.
Great. So I'll start with the introduction of both our speakers. First, I'll go with Nidhi, Nidhi Bharadwaj. Nidhi has more than 12 years of experience and she has worked in MNC like Alok Industry, Wellspun, and she has been handling international marketing. She's traveled across the world, places like Istanbul, Europe, and a lot of other countries with regards to her experience. So she has a huge experience in the textile industry. She's also an alumni of Indian School of Image Management. So proud alumni, yay. And after completing her program from Indian School of Image Management, she founded her own image consulting firm with the name Crafting Image by NS. She conducted workshop on image at different universities in Lucknow, in Pantnagar, and she's working also as an image consultant for a firm in Lucknow. She's also simultaneously working on implementing image courses in schools and college level in Lucknow, preparing modules along with other trainers in Lucknow, as she believes really, really into in collaboration. She says collaboration is the key to success, and I totally second that. She was also one of the trainers for grooming session. She actually was the only trainer for the grooming session for Fresh Face 2019 in Mumbai, which is organized every year by Times of India. So that was a huge honor. Not only that, Nidhi also has started her own salon, which is Glam Studio. It's a unisex salon located in Lucknow and just a few months old. I think 7 to 8 months old, Nidhi.
Yes, 7 months.
7 months old. Great. So that's about Nidhi, and I welcome you once again. And then I want to just move on to our second panelist, Sunita. Now, Sunita is, again, student and alumni of Indian School of Image Management, but that's not her only introduction. Sunita is the face behind S Factor Salon, and I'll just give you a little bit about her journey. So she's a science graduate and MBA in marketing, and she has also done her postgraduate diploma in advertising and PR and market research from MICA. Now, she started as an advertising professional in the strategy and servicing department, and then moved on to work as marketing consultant, where she worked with diverse products, and she put she was just by default put into handling primarily beauty and lifestyle brands. So that's where her journey into grooming and beauty industry actually started. She then went on to work with top importers of premium hair care, skincare brands, handling their national Indian portfolios. So if you would like to know, she's been associated with the India launch of Tony and Guy DIY range. She was also, you know, associated with the launch of many brands like Label M, Olaplex, and besides that, handling a host of other renowned beauty brands like Cheryl, Super Silk, and other. You know, there's a long list actually to name a few. And yes, she has been working in this industry for a very long time. And then because she has this very people-centric personality and she's passionate about her profession. So she's well informed about the brands, the trends, the practices, innovation. And then she, you know, joined and actually learned image consulting, and she is now combining her knowledge of the skin care, skin and hair and grooming, and combining it with the personality and, you know, face analysis and all the technical bits and image management branding. And she's just giving the best suited advice and services to her clients. So welcome, Sunita. And I'm glad to have you both on board today. And this is a great, great honor to have two industry experts. So welcome once again.
Thank you so much, Sonia, for such an elaborated introduction.
Well, there is so much to say about both of you. Like, I think I cut short a few things, but
that is enough. And it was a wonderful, wonderful introduction. Thank you so much.
Great, great. So let's begin with our session today. We have a lot of people who have joined us. So let's begin with our today's topic, which is all about grooming. Now, we are in a situation which is not the most ideal, and a lot of people were actually questioning, why do you want to talk about grooming? That's not on top of everyone's mind. But I think this is the need of the hour. Eventually, we need to ask these questions and, you know, get involved into basically grooming ourselves, because it's very critical, as we all know, very critical to just the more you groom yourself, present yourself better, keep yourself hygienic and well presented, it is good for your mental well-being also. And talking about that, I have been seeing a lot of videos for the past, I think it's been a trend of last maybe 2 weeks or something, that is cropping up on all the various social media platforms, where there are DIY you know, videos on how to get your hair color done or root touch up done and gray, you know, cover your grays at home. So I want you to maybe just begin with, you know, hair, because that's like everywhere on social media. Okay, so let's just start with the hair. And if you could just share some facts about hair colors, and because a lot of people are now doing it at home, so they are always confused which one to buy, like, you know, ammonia free, no ammonia, and ammonia and ammonia free. Then you have different values, and then two colors do not, of two different brands, do not match. So if you can just give some insights on hair color, just give us some facts.
To begin with, the trend that we've been seeing on social media these days, and while it is very, very tempting to go and ape them, because we see these cute videos of celebrities cutting their spouse's hair or their own hair,
right.
But there's the other side of the story as well. It could, you know, while it is very fascinating, and, you know, since we all have time and, you know, we all have time at hand, basically, we are all bored at home. And the attempt to do something which is life-changing is very, very, you know, on. So we all feel that we could do something.
Right.
But on that note, the advice would be to everybody that please stay away. Put those scissors away at least. Indulge into self-care. This is the time to indulge into self-care. We, as salon owners, have faced cases where momentary impulses have caused months of regrets. So that's where we do not really want you to go. Well, this is the time to indulge into care. Give the hair the tender care that it requires. All the while, when we are on the go, we subject our hair to a lot of abuse. We chemically treat it. We all the time are blow drying our hair, straightening our hair, using irons on ironing continuously. I mean, we don't let it rest. So this is the time to let it rest and indulge and give that all the tender, loving care that we can give. As we are not stepping out, great time to indulge in some home care.
Yeah, so adding on to Sunita, I would just suggest certain home care, how we can care, you know, your hair at home. Like, we all normally, I think, frequently go for the hair spas at the salon, and we all are missing badly, like, how to go for that hair right. nourishment. So as Sunita suggested, like, there is a proper way of hair cutting. And if, you know, just seeing certain videos, you are thinking that you would be able to cut your hair, then please forget it. Because even at my salon, there are n number of people, they try, cut it, and they have to actually wait for more longer period, you know, to get their hair back in shape, the kind of cut they really want. So please don't try it. And rest is up to you. We can only suggest to you. And for the home care, like, if I would say, the simple could be, if you have some olive oil, or you have some, even the coconut oil, whichever you want to apply, just warm it a bit, do a little scalp massage, and then followed by some, you know, hot towel steaming. But immediately after steam, given the hot towel steam, don't go for the washing of your hair. Wait for some time, because it is hot, and suddenly you are exposing your hair to, you know, again to the normal water. Then there's a temperature difference, then chances of hair fall is more. So wait for certain time and then wash it off with a certain mild shampoo. The shampoo could be mild in terms of, could be the sulfate free, right, Sunita, or could be a normal. So when we talk about what are the sulfate free shampoo and why the sulfates are being added in the shampoo, so there are two things to it. First, if we are talking sulfate is a chemical, like, which attract oil and water. So when oil and water, and it creates the foam also. When we are washing our hair, the foam is coming, then we all are having that, you know, bath type of feeling that, okay, something good is happening with us, and some good, you know, fragrance is coming out. But the other side of it, if someone is having really itchy, you know, very dry scalp, then what sulfates does, it removes all the oil from your scalp. So if your hair are a little dry and little itchiness, then please go for a sulfate-free shampoo itself. It's always mentioned on the bottles, and all the big brands, they're already promoting it too much. Although we all may be already buying it, but we may not be aware about the fact, like, why sulfate has been added and why, you know, sulfate-free shampoo. Sunita, you want to add on to something to this?
So there are different kind of shampoos and conditioners meant for different kind of hair. And it is very essential that we know what shampoo and conditioner works for us. The same shampoo and conditioner which could be great for me may not work for you. And that is why it is extremely important for us to know our hair type. So supposing we have fine hair, fine limp hair, and we end up using a shampoo which is very heavy and a conditioner which is very heavy, the hair would just fall flat and it'll have no body. Whereas there are shampoos which are meant to add body to your hair. Those are great shampoos to use for people with finer hair. And then there are shampoos which, if you have very dull, dehydrated hair, then you have shampoos which could add moisture to it. So these are, and it is very essential to be able to discriminate which product you use for what kind of hair. Right. So that is why, but you would generally know if your hair is finer, use a shampoo which will give you a volume. If your hair is very dull and dehydrated, use a shampoo which is meant to add moisture. And apart from that, as she rightly said, sulfate-free shampoos become an essential product for chemically treated hair. A lot of treatment, when we do a lot of treatment, we are advised to use sulfate-free shampoo and conditioner because they're much milder.
Right.
And they prolong the treatment that much longer.
Right, right, right. Yeah, I think that's a great advice. And my biggest takeaway is that this is the time for self-care, which is a very good advice. I think that's something that everyone can just take back. That it's not just in grooming, like we talk about a lot of things. It's about body care. It's about even your mental well-being. Your
time to indulge.
Yeah. Just one point, Sonia, I want to add. Like there is a research also shows that only 0.5 inch of your hair length grows in a 4 weeks time.
Okay.
So got people it. Who have long hair,
yeah,
they can easily manage it,
right.
Because only lesser. But people, I think, especially for men, it would be a little problem,
right.
Because they have little shorter hair.
Right.
So for them, I think they have to relax for some time, as long as they are not going out somewhere. So it's a little bit challenge, but
right.
Maybe they can do little trimming if they really want, certain.
Right.
If there is some Zoom meeting like we are doing and bosses really want you to be, neat and
proper.
Clean. Yeah, proper. That may
there are ways to do it. Do go and watch those videos. equip yourself as much as you can,
yeah.
And then only attempt it.
Right. I think I should have just taken your advice, Sunita, on putting those scissors away. And now, I'm sorry, Ashwin, I'm apologizing to you on live right now that I just attempted that. And the end result was that he was left with no hair because I just went, I tried and then it just went so horrible. I announced that, Ashwin, you're going bald now. And just trimmed off everything.
There is, while hair is instant gratification, it could be long-term disaster as well.
Yes.
So, let's just check on to our impulses.
Right.
There is a time and, professionals are waiting to attend to their hair.
Correct, so, correct. Yeah. And on this topic, I think we just got a question also, which kind of, Nidhi, you touched upon, Padmaja has asked, what about boys, especially my son has fast-growing hair, which is always covering his face and it's impossible to wait for the salon to open now. So what would you advise?
Well, he could go in for a little bit of trimming under supervision,
uh-huh.
But don't try. So, since he's a young kid, one could look at, grooming him to an extent that he's comfortable if he cannot hold on.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're really looking for those fancy haircuts, that's where we come in and we say, put away those scissors. But yeah, if it is it is something which you have to do, try and take some tutorials. I know it is very tough, but then take as much care as you can and do groom yourself. It's not that, he's a small kid and I know he would be finding it a little difficult to manage it. He could try hair bands. He could try some fancy stuff. But
right.
If not, do it with caution.
I would just add on to it, go for some very basic styling, maybe just for the trimming a bit. Don't try, very advanced haircut or something after seeing the videos, because that's
right.
Impossible. There's
right.
A proper training for hairdresser. Even
right.
Getting their training after 1-2 years time, they are able to really perform on clients.
True.
Yeah.
True.
So
yeah.
Just maybe you can go for a little bit trimming here and there, not more than that.
I think that's a very important point. And I would just give an analogy over here because I love those. So there is a reason that WebMD is not a doctor and we still go to clinics. So similarly, hairstylists, they know what they're doing and you should rely on them and not try to do with, what they are doing. All those videos are made by people who are hairstylists themselves. They have the training and that's why they are able to do it at home. So it's not that they are normal people who just happened to pick up the scissor and started doing it. So I would just agree with Nidhi and Sunita both that don't try that. Yes. And now that you spoke about shampoos, the sulfate-free and, something that is more heavier. So Padmaja again is asking that where do we get those shampoos? And if we are not able to get hold on the sulfate-free, any home remedies which can, keep the hair in this time period better?
आपको द माइल्डर शैम्पूज वुड डू बेटर हियर. Let's understand shampoos and conditioners.
Right.
So yes, a lot of people also have this thing that is conditioner, using conditioner a must. Should we right. always condition when we shampoo our hair? So right. on that note, you know, hair and skin has a pH, mm-hmm. which is like the normal pH of hair and skin is between 4.5 to 5.5. Right. Now, what anything which cleanses does is that product has to be alkaline, mm-hmm. and it would cleanse. So mm-hmm. the milder it is, I mean, if you're washing your hair. Daily, if somebody who uses a shampoo very frequently, mm-hmm. then you should look for milder products because your hair is not going to get that dirty.
Correct.
And you could do with milder products.
Right.
And if you are somebody who washes, takes a long gap between the washes, then you should be using something which is more, a little more alkaline and would cleanse it a little better. Or you could do double rinses and, you know, triple rinses depending on what is your hair condition. Yes. So at this point of time, since you, if you cannot go get hold of some shampoo which is really sulfate free, right. look for a shampoo which is very mildly alkaline.
Right.
Okay. So look for the pH. The pH has to be as close to the normal pH as it is possible. And then definitely, definitely use a conditioner because conditioner is acidic. So when you use a shampoo, the conditioner gets it back to the normal pH. Conditioner is always acidic, so right. you know, look for a milder shampoo, and I think you can wait till the time this is over. Use yeah. as mild a shampoo. If you have a baby shampoo, go ahead and use it.
Yeah, actually, yeah, and those are very easily available, I guess.
Yeah, adding on to it, some home remedy again, if we talk about then sure. if you don't have, you only have a shampoo right now, you don't have a mask, then I think curd is a really very old remedy, you know, to give a little sheen on your hair. So just apply after washing, just towel dry it, apply a little bit curd on, leave it for 15 minutes and then again rinse it. You'll see the kind of, you know, shine and softness coming in your hair. And followed by it, if you will just wash it with a normal water and apply, do the oiling, that the oil massage on your scalp, and then again next day morning you wash it, it's wonderful. I have already used it, so it's a really good formula.
And on that note, to keep your hair looking great and as vibrant, if you have colored hair and the color has started getting duller,
right.
You could use apple cider vinegar. Wow. It is acidic, but don't use it in the concentrated form, diluted. So it, like in a liter's bottle, add probably a spoonful of apple cider vinegar.
Right.
That will be a little acidic. And do the last rinse with it if you do not have conditioner.
Correct.
So what it will do is it will smoothen the cuticle, get the shine back to the hair, will refresh the color as well.
Correct. I'm a big fan of apple cider vinegar because I have a lot of density in my hair. So I just have to use that at times sometimes to get through also. Like, you know,
yes,
conditioner does not get in at times. So
apple cider. A little more apple cider vinegar because you have voluminous hair.
Yeah.
People with finer hair would use a little less.
Right. All right. We are getting like the storm of questions. So we'll have to maybe, you know, be picky in what we answer. But just a few more things. I will take the questions in between whenever that we are discussing that topic. So please hold on. But just when we are on the topic of hair, I also want you both to cover a little bit about hair color, because I'm seeing these really, and especially this cute video of this really old couple that where the guy was actually, you know, covering the grays and giving a rude touch up to his wife. It is so adorable. But yes, any tips on what to look for when you're supposed to do these rude touch ups and like color, just give a little insights on color.
While color is something which we all do, sometimes it is a necessity because we're covering our grays, sometimes as a fashion statement and sometimes for both. Right. So color is something which is very, very important and almost all of us color our hair.
Right.
But despite the fact, you know, that it is a very common treatment, it has also earned a bad name because people think it is chemically laden and then, you know, it harms your hair and stuff. Right. But the fact is, yes, it is a chemical. But everything is a chemical.
Yes.
You know, even water has a chemical composition. It is H2O.
Right.
So the choice is really between, you know, using a harmful chemical and a safe chemical. Okay. So that's where we are. And most of the permanent hair colors that we use in the salons have ammonia. And again, ammonia is a bad guy. You know, everybody says that, you know, you should be using ammonia free color.
Right.
But ammonia really, let's understand ammonia first. Ammonia is something which is actually required in order for the color to penetrate into the hair. So what ammonia does is it opens the cuticle, hair cuticle, and that's how the color can go into the hair. So the result which you get after using a color with ammonia is something which is vibrant hair and longer lasting color.
Right. So
while ammonia is very essential, there is a school of thought which says that, you know, ammonia is a bad guy and we want color which is ammonia free.
Right.
Let's just understand, no permanent color can be without ammonia.
Right.
So the question to ask is, if there is no ammonia, what is in it? Because there has got to be an agent which is doing the job of ammonia.
Correct.
Mostly it is a mast ammonia. It is a derivative of ammonia.
Right.
So the most popular ingredient being MEA, which is methyl, ethyl ammonia. So
right.
It is a form of ammonia. Mm-hmm. Basically, the aroma, the fragrance is mast.
Right.
Why ammonia is identified? Because you can smell ammonia.
Right.
This probably you cannot smell ammonia because the molecular size is bigger.
Mm-hmm.
What ammonia does is it does its job of opening the cuticle and it evaporates.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas MEA actually sits on the scalp. So you cannot smell ammonia, but if not more, it is equally damaging
right.
to the hair. So let's get rid of some myths that, you know, if you're using an ammonia free color, you're using a safer
right.
color. So go ahead and, you know, this choice still lies with
right.
you. But that is a basic difference. And the other type of ammonia-free color is basically the funky colors.
Hmm.
So if it doesn't have ammonia, then it just coats. It just sits on the surface of the hair. It doesn't penetrate.
Right.
So it's going to wash off subsequently with each wash.
Correct.
So if you're looking for funky colors, the blues, the greens, the reds, go in for these ammonia colors.
You on me.
Nidhi has a bit of green there.
Right. Yeah. So talking about the colors, so... when in salon, like, you know, normally the consultation is really important. What kind of client is coming? Being a client, you should also be knowing, like, you know, what kind of color you should opt. So Sunita has already elaborately, you know, told about this.
Right.
So coming to our side, being a other side of the salon, being a owner side, when clients are coming, we take care, like if some students are coming, of course, we are not going to advise them something which is really permanent because they keep trying.
Right.
So if we'll keep telling, okay, no, and at the same time, they cannot afford such expensive colors.
Right.
And they also want that, no, no, ma'am, we want these colors.
Right.
So as per the client, it also depends what kind of colors we can suggest them.
Mm-hmm.
Like if it's a fashion color, because being in salon and I have to keep trying different colors and for my clients, so that when clients are coming, they're seeing on me and then they're like, ma'am, I want this kind of color, you know?
Right.
So because tangibility is really important.
Hmm.
So until something you are able to see it, you are only imagining it. It's really impossible to understand about it.
Right.
So that's the way we pitch about, you know, about the colors. And coming to the ammonia and ammonia free segment. So we have, if some, I can see there are now people, they are so much aware. They're coming and asking me, ma'am, we want Innova free, like Innova only. Because in Laurel, there is a Majoral, there is Innova. So Majoral is ammonia. And so-called, and Innova is the ammonia free, right? So the normally the elder people who are 40 plus or 45 plus for their gray coverage, although then they have to come frequently because the color is not being penetrated to their cortex level, like the inner level of the hair. But in their, you know, mindset, it's been created from the all the advertisement and everything that it's ammonia free, so it will damage their scalp lesser than the color which has ammonia.
Hmm.
So anyhow, we try to educate them a bit. Although when someone is like some brand is using some call outs, like it's ammonia free, then of course there is a lesser amount of ammonia
right.
as compared to the ammonia product. So as per the age segment and as per the client requirement, if they face some itchiness with the, you know, the ammonia kind of colors, then we suggest them. And for the student kind of people who really, you know, who would be visiting us, maybe every month, ma'am, now I want to change the color. Then we have to keep suggesting. And those were the Chinese colors. Now I don't know from where we'll get these colors.
Right. So that's a very good insight, I think, to understand from the salon perspective that what you are also suggesting. And I think having that awareness is really important now, because as a customer, you are now more informed. You make the choice of, you know, you are aware about what you're going for, and you're not just blindly choosing what the marketing gimmick of these brands are being done by, and you're saying
true.
That ammonia is the bad guy. But in fact, this is something that I have observed also, that if you wear or you put on the non-ammonia or the ammonia-free color, it just fades away so faster. So you're actually going again and again, if, especially if you're getting it done for your grays, you're going and visiting the salon more frequently and getting more and more color in your hair.
You can't really achieve a lot of color. So if you're looking at fashion color, you may not be able to achieve it. You can just achieve a basic color.
Right.
And it is basically in terms of texture or in terms of results or in terms of vibrancy, the colors with ammonia are better. And actually, as I said, in terms, there is a derivative of ammonia there. It is just, you know, the way we can call it ammonia free because ammonia in its own form is not there.
Its own form, correct. I think that's a very big insight into the colors, and now we are more aware. So that's great. I think I want to now, because we also have very limited time, and this topic is something that we can go on, and with your experience, the both of you that bring in, I think we can just have like a 2-hour session or a 3-hour session on this. So I will just take quickly a few questions from the audience which are hair related before I move on to the skin, because I want to touch upon that as well. So one of the questions that has come from Shraddha, and first of all, she's saying hi to both of you. And her question is, how often should we wash hair in a week if you have an oily scalp? So let's just quickly answer that, and then I can bounce more questions.
Yeah. Hi, Shraddha. Shraddha, so if you have an oily scalp, then for sure, like, there is too much accumulation of oil, right? Mm-hmm. So firstly, I want to know how many times right now you're like washing your hair. I think maybe twice or thrice, right?
I think somewhere around that. Let's see in the comments what she says.
So, and anyhow, being an oily scalp, so it's just that you should not be using more of, you know, this sulfate free shampoo. If you're using a normal shampoo, that's okay with you, because sulfate gonna, you know, keep more oil to your scalp. Sulfate free shampoos, right? So you can use sulfate shampoos which are having sulfate in it. That's fine with you. First point. The second point is, if there is a degree of, you know, oil on your hair, so that's where examination, the, you know, that consultation comes under, where we physically examine the client's scalp with the lenses, and then we can suggest quite, you know, finally that this should be the way. But right. Otherwise, if you're washing twice in a week or maybe thrice in a week, that's quite fine with you, and there you are not damaging your hair also, because some people, they have a myth that, you know, frequent washing would damage their hair. So there's nothing like it, because if, although you already have a oily scalp, and now summer is coming, so more of sweat gonna also accumulate, so it's better to wash it out rather than, you know, keeping it on your hair.
True.
Can I add something here?
Sure, go ahead.
A very interesting product that, you know, we should be using. Shraddha, you said your hair is your scalp is oily,
right?
So If you, for some reason, if you cannot wash your hair, and please remember that there's no harm washing hair. Wash it as frequently as you wish to, because, you know, and as and when you see oil into it, because go by your own judgment.
Right.
There is no expert tip there, because letting the oil accumulate and the dirt accumulate will do you more harm than washing it more frequently.
Right.
But in case you cannot wash it, there's this great product that I have here. I do not really want to show you the brand name, but this is called Dry Shampoo. So I'm a great product holder, so I have a couple of brands here, and these are called dry shampoos. So dry shampoo is an excellent product which will come to your rescue when you do not really want to wash your hair. All that you need to do is you need to pat your hair, spray it on, and then brush it off.
Yeah.
Your scalp is clean. You know, your oils, the scalp oil has been absorbed. Your hair could be again, and it will feel fuller. Great tip for people who have fine hair. So if your hair is falling flat, dry shampoo is a great product to use. So this is another product which will come to your rescue.
Right.
And just in case you do not have the time to hoard products like me, use talcum powder maybe.
Right.
So, use it and then brush it off. It'll absorb the oil, and your hair would be good to go for at least a day or two.
I think dry shampoo is like my must-have thing whenever I'm traveling, especially because with the hair length that I have, it's impossible to keep washing and drying, and it's just like a production task. So dry shampoo is such a good thing which comes for a rescue. So I think that's a great suggestion.
especially people with longer hair, because the end tends to get drier while the scalp is oily. So this product comes really handy.
Wonderful. All right, let's quickly take so a few more questions. There are 10 more. So just on hair, and then we'll move on to the, on the skin bit. So Nikki is asking, her hair is not very great, and any tips to improve hair growth?
If I know Nikki, Nikki has lovely hair.
Even Mihir is asking for hair growth. So there are a couple of people who are just asking hair growth. So yeah, if you can just give tips on hair growth.
All the people who are asking for hair growth have great hair. Long hair, in fact.
So I would say for healthy and long hair, the basic is your dietary habits.
Yes.
So before applying any products, improve on your diet. If you want, I can share the diet plan with me, because I have a dietitian also. So if you're having a proper diet, then of course your hair texture, your hair volume, and take less stress. Everyone is having stress, right? But you should having an alternate plan. Maybe you can gym at home, or maybe you can work out at home during this lockdown situation if you're unable to, go out. Because I can understand, like, some people who has a, habit of going out every day, and suddenly everyone is locked down, then it's really a difficult situation to handle and cope up with. So why don't we try and, opt for certain alternate solution to it, rather than just thinking and, having more stress and having more hair fall. And regarding the products, I think we have already told about the, home, that spa thing, hair spa. You can try that hair spa. That will help you. And eat lot of, raw food, like all the salads, fibrous, oranges. Lot of things are there you can try. And if you really want detail, just send us something on personal. We will send you all the detail, and then you can follow for a week, and then you can see the changes.
Wonderful. And Sunita, you want to add on to something?
Another great product, because we on an average we use a lot of product, and shampoos, conditioners, serums, and a whole lot of other products. And sometimes we also realize that the same shampoo and conditioner, which was working great for us some time back, has stopped being so great for our hair. So the reason mostly is because your scalp tends to have a coating of the products over time when you go on using. So it is very essential to deep cleanse your scalp as well. So there are products called clarifying shampoos, which you should be using, say, once a month in order to get rid of all the buildup on the scalp, so that the product starts getting better into the hair and your hair starts looking better. The nutrients are absorbed better once you use a clarifying shampoo on your hair once in a while. Maybe once a month is a good frequency.
Great. I think those are good tips. And means there are other tips which are secret tips that I can give you. So later on, you can just ping me.
Yes, considering Sonia has such long hair.
That's genetic. That's nothing. That's my genes.
Sonia is definitely your go-to person if you want tips on long hair.
I've just inherited it. Nothing else, actually. All right. Now we will, I think we are really pressed on time. So let's do quick tips. So like a rapid fire thing on the questions that are coming in. So Charlie is asking, what do you do when your original straight hair starts turning a little curly? And Anita also wants to know the same answer.
Well, like everything, nothing remains the same. Right. So acceptance is a big thing. Yes, textures would change over time. You may be born with straight hair, and you could see that it is curling over time, or curly hair getting straighter.
True.
We may not like the scenario, we may like the scenario, but the best place to begin would be to accept it, because hair does change over time, because there are hormones playing on, there are products, there are stress levels, everything is playing on, and we can't really pinpoint, and there is no singular reason for why the texture changes. So the good way would be to accept it and get a haircut which is customized to the present texture that you have. That will work great with you. Moisturize, that always works. Hydrate, keep it hydrated. And the best thing would be to adapt a haircut which would work for the present texture that you have.
And Nidhi, what's your quick tip on this?
My quick tip would be, I think it's a lockdown, so we cannot really suggest anything related to salon. But although as soon as those things are normal, then keratin is a thing which really helps people to even for the curly hair and even for the straight hair. For both the hair, keratin is a kind of food for, it's a protein, it's a food for your hair.
Right.
So if you're fed up with, you know, keep doing straightening or keep doing rebonding and keep, you know, curling or whatever, different aspects. So try keratin once, because a lot of pollution, we are surrounded with a lot of pollution and, you know, we are exposed to sun, we are exposed to so many chemicals, we are already using colors on hair, we are using so many things. So why not give food to your hair also? So I would suggest when things are normal, you can try keratin. That would really help.
Right. Let's hope things get settled down soon. All right. And now you both have to give quick tip only. So Nilufar is asking, is it necessary to put on a conditioner every time you wash your hair, especially if you're in a rush?
As I mentioned, Nilufar, we did cover this topic a little earlier. Yes, conditioner is a must. As I said that, you know, the shampoo alters the pH of the hair. And when the pH is altered, your cuticles are left open and, you know, your hair is more vulnerable to external damages.
Right.
So conditioner would seal it. Conditioner would get it back to the normal pH. And your hair would be looking great for a longer time. It'll be shinier, smoother, and, you know, normal to the pH. So it is in its original form, and it works really well for the hair.
True. And Nidhi,
and your hair will get damaged lesser, because when you're only washing and going out, then of course you know more dirt and more everything gonna more, you know, clink on your hair. So why can't we save it? So
yes,
use a mask or a conditioner.
That's true, very true. In fact, sometimes I means conditioning and then leave-in, like both of them I just kind of do together. So because of maybe the density, it gets drier at the ends or something like that. So I personally would recommend that you do a leave-in and rinse off both of them, at least for if you have lot of length, if you can tell me if that's right or not.
You can't do it together though, because the pHs are contradictory, but yes, okay. You could quickly do a rinse and then quickly, you know, if you do not have time to let it stay for a longer time, quickly give it a rinse.
Right.
Use a mask instead, which is heavier. So even if you put it for a lesser time, it'll give you the same result.
Okay. I'll try that next time. All right. So now we're going to move on to the skin, because we have all left with only 15 minutes. So I don't know how much we'll be able to cover. But moving on to skin, if you can just like quickly give some tips on, especially in this lockdown situation, people have gone all experimental with their, you know, hair, and then with their skin also. Like there are people who are doing, trying to do facials at home, making their own recipes of facials and, you know, masks. Then I see a lot of people tweezing their hair and all. So, and guys trying to grow beard, and, you know, then it's not working out. So there is just like a complete chaos happening, which I keep seeing. So let's start with skin, maybe facial hair, especially eyebrows and upper lip or something like that. And then let's move on to the skin, few tips. And then we can talk about guys and beard and managing hair also. Yeah. So who wants to go first?
Hello. Yes. Am I audible?
Yes, Nidhi, you are audible. You can start.
Yeah. So regarding the skin, if we talk about, so first thing would be the facial. I think we all are missing badly right now. Right.
Yeah.
So if I give certain tips about a home facial with the home products, I think that would work with everyone right now.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So there are six steps for a facial. So the first would be the cleansing, then exfoliating, then gel, then massage, then pack, and then the SPF, right? We all are aware about it. So coming to the cleansing, so if we see like during the lockdown, we don't have any, maybe some people might be having cleanser with them and some people may not be having the cleanser with them.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to have a cleanser at home, so why not try a milk? So milk has a lactic acid, like it's a deep pore cleanser. So we can add milk with maybe rose water or maybe with the turmeric or maybe with the... It all varies as per type. So if anyone is really want to know the detail, I can text them for what skin, what kind of combination would work.
Right.
So we can have a cleanser ready at home.
Right.
So followed by cleanser, cleansing, we can also have an exfoliator at home. So we all having a coffee with us, right? So we can add coffee with the yogurt and mix it well and keep it for some time. And then a very nice, you know, home exfoliator is ready and it's really good. It's going to give you, so coffee has antioxidants. So that's going to give a really, you know, youthfulness that gives a more freshness on your skin. And it really works well for, I think, all kind of skins. Because I have tried, even one of my cousins, she tried. She was having oily skin and I'm having a normal skin. So coffee works for both the type of skin. And followed by exfoliator. And the point to be added for exfoliation is you should not be doing too much of exfoliating. The frequency should not be much. Because some skin, they have very, for the very fine skin, it may damage the skin also. So as we all not professionally trained for this, so let's not do this for more than 5 to 10 minutes, because even the pressure is also important. What kind of pressure you're putting while doing, you know, scrubbing on your face.
Right.
So just don't do it very frequent, very too much pressure with the too much pressure and for the long time.
Right.
And followed by that, we can have a, if you have gel available, that's okay. Aloe vera gel, or if you have some other gel, then that's okay. Otherwise, we can omit that step. And after that, we can have a massage with certain, you know, moisturizer, whatever available to you. And then we can have a mask, which is homemade, like, because now summers are there. Like, so for the summers, I think for the cucumber, honey and yogurt mask is the best. And maybe some people can have orange or turmeric mask. So there is a various kind of mask available for each type of skin type. I can share it with you all, like during this lockdown, who all can try it.
I think just to wrap it up, Nidhi, sorry, but maybe the best thing is that, you know, take down the steps and just like reach out to both our panelists, because they are really willing to share all the information.
A lot of things
and,
are
there. There is so much, and then there are so many factors like skin and what is your type, what are the kind of place you're living in.
Yes.
So
exactly,
it's just like impossible to cover everything over here. But Sunita, if you can maybe just like on the steps that Nidhi just gave, and give a few tips on the skin, but because Nidhi has already covered on the skin bit, maybe you want to talk about the hair, skin, facial hair and beard bit.
So facial hair, again, beard is no different than the scalp hair. It's just that men have it and we have it on scalp, and they also have it on their face.
Right.
So as far as beard is concerned, it does require, give it the same tender care that we were talking about the hair on scalp. Do wash it, condition it, also use a leave-in conditioner if need be.
Yeah.
And the hair underneath, which the skin underneath also needs some care. So do some exfoliation on that part, moisturize.
Mm-hmm.
And if you are somebody who is wanting to have a graphic, really different kind of beard, creative beard, then you may have to wait. Otherwise, go ahead and do your basic grooming. All of us have, I'm sure all of you have your trimmers and all that. So if it's a basic trimming, go ahead and do it, indulge in it. But if you're looking for some creative beard styling, then you might have to wait. Till the time, give it the tender care, you know, wash, shampoo, condition, moisturize, and you're good to go.
Right.
I would just add on one point. Yeah, regarding the beard, I think why don't we like go for that quarantine beard challenge? Just follow that. Even if you see the follow the Jim Carrey, he's been posting from 23rd of March, I believe,
right,
on his Insta. So now, you know, try to follow the different trends so that you are also in trend, in line with the time what we are, you know.
Yeah. Yes. Then I think one thing to add over there is that you need to maintain hygiene, because beard can be really, really dangerous when it comes to hygiene, and you want to be hygienic also in this situation. Sunita, you were saying something.
Yeah, so I'm saying, as Nidhi said, you know, all those people who always wanted to grow beard, but they were not allowed for some reason, you know, because it was not considered formal or something. This is your time.
Yeah, so do it. This is advice coming from both salon expert, that this is your time. Just try and experiment, because you couldn't do it otherwise in your formal situation. I'll just quickly now move on from grooming, and now I want to understand from you a little bit on the trends and where the industry, because you both come from salon industry. So where, what is going to be the upcoming trend? Because now they are shut. And if I remember, the salons were the first few places, like mall, salon, were the first few places, gyms and all, to get shut down. So even when they will open up, do you expect any kind of difference in the trends or consumer behavior or even purchasing? So what is your input on this?
Immediately, I think we'll see a rush of clients because they've all been waiting for us to open up.
Right.
So yes, when we open up and we are already getting inquiries, and I know we're all used to this, has become so much a part of us that, you know, we go to salons. So yes, to begin with, we may see a rush into the salon. It may not sustain because like everything else, we would also get into that zone where people have done it once and, you know, then they want to take the time off because the economy in general is not doing so well, so everything is going to get affected.
Right.
So are we. So to begin with, and when we open up, hygiene is the way to go.
Yes,
so the
yes.
masks, no hugging, no shaking hands. We may be missing them for too long, but we would still be okay with a hi, hello.
Right.
And masks and sanitizers are the way to go.
Yes.
And yes, and as far as the trends are concerned, we are already seeing, you know, the hairstyles and textures and colors, which are more closer to your natural texture.
Right.
And not going something which is too much away from your natural texture or your natural skin and hair.
Right.
The drastic treatments are not so much in these days. The high maintenance things, unless you're somebody who's committed to invest that kind of money and time into products, is not really something which is recommended.
Right.
Going for cuts and colors which you can maintain at your convenience, and you know, you do not have to spend too much maintaining
right.
it.
Right. I think, yeah, those are very great inputs. And even I was kind of thinking that maybe that could be the reality, that people are coming more closer to what their actual natural style is. Nidhi, what's your view on this? What do you think would be the new trends?
Yeah. So as for me, people would be more, you know, focused towards the brands. They will follow more brands because somewhere hygiene, like they're, you know, till now we have to convince the client that why the brands are different from the non-brand and why brands are maintaining hygiene levels, right? So now as people are already aware that hygiene is so much important for each of us, so for sure there would be a good, you know, from the clientele side, we can see that they are able to judge that why brands are expensive than non-brands, because they are maintaining hygiene. And, you know, we were keeping the sanitizers at salon before this COVID-19. So we were already following those things. Although after lockdown, I feel there would be a win-win situation for the brands because they are already following these things. They're already maintaining hygiene. So the price categories are different. So now client is aware that where they have to go. And secondly, talking about the trends, if we see, so people anyhow, we all were struggling for the time. No one has time. You know, everyone, if some clients are coming to the salon, they always used to ask even before that, ma'am, suggest certain kind of hairstyle, which is really easy to maintain. So I believe now hair treatments would be more than the normal hair, you know, spas. So hair treatments, because they give a solution for the long time. So if someone is taking a rebonding or someone is taking a, you know, keratin treatment, then they do not have to visit salon and again, just using the products of their, you know, at home, they're able to maintain their hair. Right. So I believe the hair treatment's going to be more upcoming trends rather than having more kind of, you know, haircuts with small fringes and all, which needs more, you know, you have to keep visiting the salon.
Correct.
So the people will go for the more value services and with the longer, long-term results.
Right.
And in terms of, if we see in terms of monetary, then of course there is a setback for all the industries and it will take little time. So we all have to be patient, you know, enough to face with it and come out with
right.
the situation.
Right. I think that those are really great inputs. And what I understand as a summary is that people will be going. It's not that it will be just like going to get a massive hit or impact, because grooming is very important part of our lives. We all are used to it and it's just way of life. But yes, there will be a more emphasis on self-sufficiency or maybe keeping styles that are more easy to maintain, but still something which is more long-lasting than doing those temporary treatments or temporary stuff which can just give that little few days of happiness, and then it's gone. So people are going to look for more value for money and more long-lasting stuff. Is that true? Can we summarize it like that?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Great. So we have a lot of more questions coming in, and I will just take one out of them, and then please take your time. I will actually urge both of you, Nidhi and Sunita, after the session today, please go on to the comment section and you can reply to all the people who are asking questions so that they get their answers, because we have really limited time. So the last question that I'm going to take is from Adarsh, and he's asking, which treatment is suggested for curly, unruly hair to tame down the frizz? Is cysteine treatment or Botox treatment is better? Which one is better?
Adarsh, cysteine and Botox both are non-formaldehyde alternatives to tame your frizz. For some reason, keratin is not has earned some bad name. So there is emphasis on non-formaldehyde free treatment. So cysteine is a non-formaldehyde treatment, and so is Botox. So these are really like more deep conditioning for your hair, and it would last you for say about 3 months. So both are equally good. I think if you're looking for not losing the volume in your hair, then Botox is the way. If you want some flatness in your hair, then cysteine is your go-to treatment.
Great. All right. So now that's for the questions that we had. And of course, you can ask more questions. Please drop your question in the comment section. Nidhi and Sunita will reply to them after the session is over. And I'm going to now get into the fun part of our session today, which is the rapid fire, because just inspired by Karan Johar. So we are going to do that. All right. So the first, what we are going to do is... start with Sunita, with you first, and then we'll go to Nidhi. Okay? So, you're ready?
Yeah.
Brace yourself. Okay. All right. So, long hair or short hair?
Short hair.
Great. Nude lips or classic red?
Sorry?
Nude lips or classic red?
Classic red.
Okay.
I see you. I'm spotting today.
What is that one beauty product that you can't live without?
Beauty products and SPF, otherwise you can't see me without a hairbrush.
Wow. Okay. What is your current morning skincare routine? Fast.
Splash water.
Love that. What was the first beauty product you ever owned?
A moisturizer.
Okay. Your favorite beauty brand?
Lauder, MAC.
Okay.
Quite a few. Yeah. MAC when we are talking makeup, it's MAC. And when we are talking skincare, it's probably Kiehl's.
Okay. And hair?
There are a host of products. But then currently, Vella.
Okay. Wonderful. What are the 5 products you always have in your shower?
Okay. Besides my shampoo, conditioner, a body wash, also a body mist, mm-hmm. and a moisturizer, and I think what, 4 products I've already covered.
Yes, one more. Quick.
And a Dior. Moisturizer.
Oh, great. If you have only 2 minutes to apply your makeup, what will you do? What will be your steps?
Quick. Okay. Moisturize, use the sunblock, conceal, lip balm, and you're done.
Wow. That's pretty simple. Setting spray or setting powder?
Setting spray.
Great. Wonderful. So that was your rapid fire, Sunita. Coming to Nidhi. Nidhi, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
We need some interesting answers from you. All right. Don't give answers which are, like something which, like in the shower, we need more answers. Because Sunita has covered the basics, so we need more than that. That's why I said
it. Oh, really?
All right, so more, you don't have the same choice as Sunita.
Oh, really?
Only on the shower question. Rest of the questions were like wonderful. Okay, long hair or short hair?
Long hair.
Okay, and setting spray or setting powder?
Setting spray.
All right, nude lips or classic red?
Nude.
And if you have only 2 minutes to apply makeup, what will be your steps? I love Sunita's, you have to top that.
Use the moisturizer.
Right.
Then that MAC compact,
uh-huh.
and then the blusher, lip, uh-huh. and eye.
Wow. Wow, 2 minutes, you'll be done with all this.
Yes.
I think I should have asked Sunita less than 1 minute, and yours will be 2 minutes. Great. Okay. Favorite beauty brand?
Favorite MAC, of course, MAC.
And for hair?
For hair, right now I'm GK.
And skincare, because Sunita gave
Blossom Couture.
Okay. And what is your current morning skincare routine?
Oh, so washing with normal like face wash.
Yeah.
And then apply a little moisturizer. That's it.
And splash water.
Yeah. First.
Right. What is the one beauty product you can't live without?
I think MAC. I cannot live without MAC. I just adore MAC, all the products.
Great. And the last question, which was the most interesting, that need interesting answers on. What are the 5 products that you have in your shower, other than the ones that Sunita mentioned?
Oh, so other than Sunita is telling, don't tell me. So I think I'll have a scrubber with me. Okay.
Yeah.
And then I'll have a good, that aroma oil, which I use, right? That's lavender I'm using right now.
Uh-huh.
Then I use certain candles sometimes, that aroma candles, because I like those kind of environments. So sometimes when I really want to go for relaxation, I use those kind of aroma candles.
That's
and fourth one would be some good, you know, spray. I think I'm too much with the aroma thing. So some good spray around me before I go for shower and as soon as it come out. And the last would be a good soft, you know, bathrobe. After to cover my head.
Yes, that was interesting. I thought means what else could be there in other than the 5 things that, you know, like your shampoo, your body wash, but that those were like really interesting. All right, I will take one more question because there are a lot of questions coming in. So Jana is joining us from Malaysia right now, and she's asking, she has asked 2 questions, that what's in your opinion better, like hair straightening or relaxing? What's your opinion on hair straightening or relaxing?
Well, straightening, it depends on the hair texture really. So if you really have virgin hair, the hair is really strong, you could go in for straightening, but straightening is an extreme treatment.
Right.
And in due course of time, it tends to weaken the hair. And it is also one of the reasons why the hair texture changes over time, because we are completely rebonding. We are rearranging the bonds in the hair. So it is an extreme treatment.
Right.
And you may not be able to do it over time. So the first time you do it, it could be great. Also, depending on your texture, do it only when you have very thick, wavy, curly hair and strong hair. Hmm. Otherwise, relaxing is a better way to go.
Okay. And Nidhi, a question for you, and this is from Lavanya, because one question for Sunita, one for you. So she's asking, her hair is thin, dry, and also she's experiencing hair fall. So what treatment, shampoo, or follow-up I need to do? If you can just give 3 steps, and then maybe in the comment section, you can recommend a few brands to her or give her more options.
So for very thin hair, like normally we don't recommend rebonding kind of treatment, right? So what I was telling in like before, that the keratin could be the very good for a thin hair, because keratin gonna give little volume to your hair also, right? So there are multiple brands available for keratin. What we are using is the GK, that is one of the very renowned and good product for the keratin.
Right.
So you can go for the keratin, and that's it, and use the keratin product. Use their mask and shampoo.
Great, great. And there are tons of questions coming in. I think rebonding. Rashmi is asking, Dr. Rashmi Rathore, she's asking that how frequently you can get rebonding done.
So as I said, rebonding is an extreme treatment. Right. And it doesn't go out of your hair unless it completely grows out or you cut your hair.
Right.
So it depends really on what is your hair growth, because the natural hair which is going to come back on your scalp will be of your normal texture. So if your hair is extremely curly, the contrast is going to be very obvious, because the remaining hair would be very straight, while your original hair which is cropping up from the scalp would be very curly.
Right.
So when it grows to about, say, 3-4 inches, you would want to redo it.
Right.
Especially just that portion. If you're not wanting to do the complete hair, just do that portion.
Right.
If you're really in need. So that is why these relaxing treatment work better, because they do not give you that kind of contrast.
Right, right.
Okay. And,
so just adding on to it, there should be an interval of minimum 6 months between any certain, because there is a rigorous chemical involved for certain processes. So there should be a minimum difference of 6 months. You should not repeat that process. Even you're going for the root touch-up of the rebonding.
Right, right. Great. Those were some really great insights. And there are a lot of questions I have. I know I have skipped a lot of questions. Yes, because we are pressed on time, we are already beyond 8:30 p.m. So I would, Nidhi and Sunita will go and will comment on your questions personally that you have asked. So please drop them in the comment section. Do not hesitate. If you have more questions, go ahead. In fact, there are so many questions that I couldn't ask any question for myself today. So I'm feeling left out, but it's still, I'll drop them in the comment section also. So please do that. Thank you to both of you, Nidhi and Sunita, for giving your time today and taking us through all these insights of right from taking care to, giving a little insight on how these products are and what works and what does not work. And a little bit on the industry also. It was a great, great session. And I think our audiences are just in love with it. They're all, a lot of great comments are coming in. Thank you. It was awesome. What an infotainment session. Great session. So it just everyone is loving it. Please go ahead and read the comments. You'll love them. And thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you so much, Sonia. Love being here. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sonia and Sunita.
Thank you, Nidhi.
All right. So that was for our session today on Grooming Trends of 2020. And yes, tomorrow we are coming up with a huge session. And this session is all about breaking the stereotype. So who we are going to have tomorrow is all the men of Indian School of Image Management coming together. We don't have a round table, so we are calling it a panel discussion. But the men of ISIM are going to come tomorrow for our panel discussion and going to talk about, breaking the stereotype. So do tune in at 7:30 p.m. We have all these amazing people coming and joining us. So do not miss tomorrow's session. Yes, I'm looking forward to it. So please do join.
Do it.
Thank you. All right. Bye.
Bye. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. Bye.